So from the standpoint of posture, we're going to make sure we maintain a nice neutral lumbar pelvic region, so don't arch the low back and don't flex around through the low back. We're going to keep about a 20 degree bend in the knee, and make sure your first move is getting your hip behind your ankle before you go through your hip hinge. That's going to allow you to bring more glute into the game. As far as the position of your pelvis goes, most people have a tendency to spin out. As they hinge forward, the hips rotate. If you think about keeping your belly button pointing towards your down foot, or maybe pointing it towards your little toe, that's going to help keep the pelvis a little more neutral as you go through the movement. And then finally, from the standpoint of range of motion, once you clear knee height, that's as far as you need to go, and come back up. It's not incorrect to go further and end up parallel to the floor, but that extra range, those 2 inches, 3 inches, whatever it may be, begins to open the door to hamstring strains, low back shearing. So in my opinion, we just get into an area where the benefits aren't outweighed by the risks. As far as loading goes, we can go with bilateral load or unilateral. My preference is to go opposite side of your stance foot for unilateral load, so that we have more of a rotational component to deal with, and the lateral hip is having to kick in a lot more to do the work. So make sure you stay neutral through the midsection, initiate that hip hinge, get your hips behind your ankle, maintain a nice neutral pelvic position, and keep a little bend in the knee to get more glute into the game.